Hi everyone, I am Nico Balbidina, and today nandito pa rin tayo sa Giyuan Eastern Samar, particularly sa Immaculate Conception Parish, sa baptistry na itong napakagandang simbahan na ito. No? Kasama natin ngayon si Parish Priest Father Edwin Lanuevo, and I'll let him introduce himself.
Okay, ako pa, sinabi niyo na po, ako si Father Edwin Lanuevo, ako po yung since 2018, the Parish Priest of the Immaculate Conception of Giyuan and Parish, and I have two brother priest here, Father Bernard Alhibe, and also Father Arturo Gonzalez. And I'm also commissioned last week, you know, by our priest, by the Presbyterium, to head the ad hoc committee that would be preparing for whatever, like activities and anything as part of the preparation, celebration of the 500 years of the faith.
So, you know, Father, I'm excited. I'm very excited to talk about this kasi buong Pilipinas ang involved dito. Pero before we go into detail dun, na-overwhelm ako sa itsura nitong baptistry na to. Aside from the shells, no, ano po bang remarkable dito sa baptistry na to?
I think the one that you see in the back, the statue of John baptizing Jesus, is also a very old statue. And also right below the statue are important people in the history of the church also buried in this baptistry area. And then it's the usual baptistry that you see, for example, in Europe, you know, old churches. And we have the painting of St. Therese of the Child Jesus on the sailing part. And in, even the structure itself, it is amazing. It's really a work of art, you know, with the shells.
Relating to it as a work of art, no, if nakikita ninyo yung mga shells, my friends, this is what one of the many things that made this church very special. Yung motif niya ng seashells. We will be seeing a special episode on this. In this room alone, ilang thousand shells na yung nakikita natin dito. It's very beautiful. Ano? So yun, Father, let's talk about the celebration of the yung pagsalubong natin sa 500th anniversary ng arrival ng pananampalataya. So, anong niluluto natin dito sa atin?
Okay, I think before I move into that, you know, I think I had that. It's just funny because we are in this baptistry church, baptistry room. Baptistry, the beginning of Christianity, and to be a Christian is to be baptized as a Christian. And this used to be the storage, the storeroom of the parish. So nobody even noticed that this existed, or neither the beauty of this baptistry. Only after Yolanda, when everything came down, and when they started gathering the stuff and cleaning up the area, that they saw there was so beautiful that was here. And at the outset, I would like to point it out as, I think that's part of the restoration. Restoration of the building and restoration of the faith. You know, we've been Christians for almost 500 years. And I think the question now is, what have you been doing? Have you really realized who you are as Christians? And what do you think would be the challenges for us for the next 500 years? Not only for the local church, but nationally as the church in the Philippines. So, as I said at the outset, I'd like to mention that our celebration in the Diocese of Borongan, and in particular in Giyuan and in the nearby parishes, is not so much about history per se, that Magellan landed in 1521 in the island of Homonhon. That's really part of the thing. But we're looking at it from the perspective of evangelization, of faith and Christianity, which is pretty much in line with what is being planned, or what's been the plan of the whole Catholic Bishops' Conference in the Philippines. So, in fact, our theme, although it's different from the Bishops' Conference theme, which is gifted to give, ours has more to do with the citation or the scripture that's being used in the rite of baptism that is taken also in Matthew. But at the end of the book of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 19 and 20. And it has to do with what Jesus told his disciples, that you go out to the world and make disciples of all nations. And how do you do it, making disciples? By baptizing them. Baptize them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And teach them. teach them of everything I have told you. So our theme is no longer focused on the first part of the activity, of the means, you know, in making disciples. We've been doing that for the last 500 years. We've been doing a lot of baptisms, a lot, as in a lot. If you check the baptismal record, we have thousands of people baptized here in Giwon and in the nearby parishes that used to be part of Giwon. So we forgot that there's the next pretty much connected and constitutive and essential, integral to the act of baptism, the next part of the command of Jesus, which says, teach them. So we're taking that as the theme for the 500-year celebration of Christianity. It's no longer just about baptizing people, making the faith, creating disciples, but it's already about teaching them, docentes eius servare. So we would like to be part of, integral part of the baptism is the teaching ministry. We're not only teaching those preparing for the baptism, we have to teach also those who have been baptized. That's why we're putting more emphasis now on ongoing formation of the lay people, not only of lay people, but even of the clergy. Because that's part of the command of Jesus, you know, teaching them. And in the teaching, we're focusing on not just the object of the faith, you know, catechesis on memorizing prayers, you know, all this memory, intellectual work, but to serve, to follow, servare, who, not the what, Jesus. More of, as you grow, we have the church is tasked to invite the baptized to an encounter according to his or her maturity, the person of Jesus. And from there, the catechesis, real catechesis, begins. It's only when one have an experience that he'd be able to appreciate the teaching, the dogmas, the doctrines of the church. Without the person of Jesus, I think everything would be empty. Okay? Everything would be just clanging cymbals, as Paul says. So you were asking me about the plan of the diocese. That would be the overall plan. And in the theme, docentes eius servare. And then we have a general plan for the celebration. It's only a one-year celebration, which will start on March 16 and 17 in Giwon as the launching parish. And why in Giwon? Because if there's any parish in the diocese that's really pretty close to history, to the landing of Magellan, is Giwon. You know, it's almost 500 years. It's been 425 years. And in less than 100 years, the church was built. For 74 years, the church was constructed, was built. And the faith as well of Giwon. And Homonon, where you had the landing, historical context, is part of Giwon. Although it's now an autonomous parish, it's now an independent parish that belongs also to the Diocese of Borongan. So our plan is not only for Giwon, but for the entire diocese. So what will be the plan? So we're in Giwon on March 16 and 17, we'll be launching everything. Launching the theme, the logo, the theme song, the prayer that we'll be praying for the whole year, and the orientation for the rest of the activities. So what will be the general structure of the celebration? The committee decided we have to divide it into three phases. You know, the first phase and all the phases will be focusing on themes. So the first phase would be from March to June, and we'll be focusing on renewal. And then from July to October, we'll be focusing on the healing and then forgiveness. And from November to February, would have the theme on faith recommitment as part of the mission. And then for the final countdown in March, before March 17, we would like to focus on gratitude as the theme. Now, a few things, you know, that we have to highlight also for the celebration. It's the logo, you know, and then the logo has the, if I think they're going to show it to you, you know, when they show this interview, had important features in it. The cross, the host, broken host, and the chalice representing the faith. And in the island of Homonon as the backdrop. And in the yellow thing in the logo, like a drawing of a galleon that points to the historical context, historical significance of the celebration. And the date as well, 1521 to 2021, as part of the logo. And in the boat, like a sailboat, and the waves, that's part of the logo, symbolizing movement. That's the looking forward. And in part of the looking forward, as I mentioned, is hopefully that we become a minor basilica. That will be one of the fruits, beautiful, marvelous fruit that the church can give us as a gift to the parish and to the diocese as well. And I think that's basically it. And then the culmination part would be exciting. And then we never told the guy, the priest or the bishop, whom we would like to invite. And I hope if he watched this, he'd already take it as an invitation, a personal invitation from myself. My brother priest, and he's now the bishop. If you're listening and if you see this interview, we would like to invite you to do us the grace and the privilege and the blessing to do the culminating mass next year, okay? Bishop Pablo David.
So yun po, Father, no? Gusto ko lang i-point out na yung celebration natin is dinivide natin sa ilang mga aspects na importante sa ating mga Kristiyano bilang mga Katoliko. Nandun yung renewal, pumasok yung healing and forgiveness, ang daming celebration, hanggang sa matatapos siya sa Thanksgiving. Paano nyo huna isip, no, ng ganito ang magiging division ng celebration natin?
Actually, I got the idea from my friend, Father Dennis Cagantas, because he's also involved with the Lima Sawa celebration. And he told me, and I agree with him, because we've been brainstorming of, as part of the teaching, you know, what would you put as input, you know, in the celebration? It's not just about coming together, praying together, rejoicing together. If the theme says about teaching, then we have to do some teaching also in the process. So we'd be doing teaching on renewal, on, you know, part, integral part, as she says, of being human and also being a Christian. It has to do with conversion and renewal, has to do with forgiveness, moving on, healing, you know, it's an actual thing. It's not just a conversion, it's not an abstraction. So we had to find people who really can talk to us and witness about healing and forgiveness. And then when that happens, hopefully, and we pray, then we can recommit ourselves in faith. Put really, you know, our feet where our mouth is, you know, where we have to do it. You know, committing ourselves, finding, you know, ways, means and ways that we can actualize the faith. And then finally, the gratitude thing, you know, we can only be grateful. At the end of the day, we can only thank God that everything happened according to His will. And I think that's basically it. And then part of the celebration, the Holy Celebration, where we put the inputs, the teaching, is the pilgrimage to 10 parishes. So in that pilgrimage, we'll be doing exhibits. We'll be putting up like time wall in every parish. And then we'll also be doing, as you see, the lectures. And at the end of the day, at the end of the celebration, would be a prayer vigil in the form of a concert. So even the theme, the theme song, has to do with the faith. It says, Salamat Pagtuo, Salamatan Pagtuo, thank you for the faith. And then we'll highlight that with other musicians in the diocese, would be able to compose music like Father Yuli Belizar, Neil, Andy, and the rest of them, or even Monsignor Pepe, Monsignor Lope, to come up with music that has to do with the faith. That would be like a wrapping up celebration, a prayer vigil, in the form of a concert, like a Tisay type, that not only they're presenting like a show, but the audience are as much part of the show as the performers. And then the final note is that this celebration would... I never told my committee members yet, would really involve the youth. You know, what happened to the youth after last year, the year of the youth? Where is the fruits of the last year's celebration of the youth? And if we propose all these activities to the majority of the people in the parishes, I think it's the rest are just like, you know, I'd rather stay in church. I'd rather be, it's a lot of demands, it's taxing. If you give it to the youth, I think they'd all be excited in other leaders in the church. But the majority should be the youth thing, you know. Involve them in the pilgrimage. We'd be moving from Giwan to the rest of the parishes where we're setting the concert, prayer, exhibits, and everything. Yeah. So we have the crowd. Hopefully, we would be able to get the crowd, the youth.
Father, talking about the crowd, no, is there a way for people, no, who are watching this na gustong tumulong? Meron po bang paraan para makontakt kayo or malaman ko ano po yung mga plans ninyo?
So we would like to invite especially people to help us, you know, tell everyone, inform them what's going on as part of the drive, the information drive, so that this becomes really a celebration. And then we need help. We need your financial support. We don't know where to get the money yet, but I said the diocese and also the economists have to be involved in this. You know, we don't know. Well, we can only trust. You know, we never thought that this church would be restored. We didn't have the money, but the church gave. And all we can do is also give, you know, the gifted and the giver.
You know, Father, this has been a good conversation. I can't help but to feel excited sa magiging celebration ng diocese, at particularly dito sa simbahan na to. Kanina, nung dumating kami, itsura pa lang, nakaka-excite na eh. For someone na hindi sanay sa ganitong mga setting, ganitong mga klaseng simbahan, mga lumang simbahan, mga magagandang artist, napaka-artistic na simbahan, hindi ko lang ma-imagine kung paano ninyo sineselebrate yung mga special na araw para sa Diyos. So, I really can't wait, and I really hope, no, na makasama rin ho namin kayo ulit sa mga panahon na pinagdiriwang ho natin ito. So, baka ho may mga parting messages po kayo sa ating mga nanonood.
Okay, thank you for coming. Thank you for paying us a visit. And also, thank you to the watchers. And we hope that these people would come back and really be part of the Diocese of Borongan and in the life of Giwon.
So thank you so much, no, for watching. For more videos like this, no, mangyaring mag-subscribe lang po kayo. And keep following us sa aming mga social media handles. I am Nico Balbidina, and I'm with Father Edwin Lanuevo of the Giwon Church, no, the Immaculate Conception Church dito sa Giwon, Eastern Samar. Thank you so much for watching CBCP News Conversations.